Hey guys, this is Kathy. Welcome back to my channel, Kathy's Favorite Things. You guys, I'm all sunburned from the fair that I went, the craft fair that I went this weekend. And sorry, I'm releasing this video on a Monday. It's supposed to be a Shaker Sunday video, but I did not record the video before I went to the craft fair. So I'm showing it today. So for this one, you know that I've been working on some fall journals, fall and Christmas, but I'm gonna show you what I made for the fall journals. So I made some shakers using lots of my sequins. You see the leaves there, some seed beads and some different color sequins. So I used some tool and I had used my sewing machine because I'm just obsessed with it and I'm sewing everything, not using glue. So there you go. I do like to put seed beads in it because I like the shaking sound that they make and it's super cool. In this case, I use index cards. So this is also going to be for the series where I give you ideas on how to use the index cards. Okay, so probably going to use that for the title also. There you go. So you see there are different size sequins in there. I don't know if you can tell, but there are some bigger orange and smaller orange, and the greens are different too. They're kind of flat. This one I doubled up the sequin, not the sequin, the index card here. And I cover the sewing part. See, this one is not covered and you can see and feel the sewing that I did. This one, I added one on the back to make it sturdier because these are not really thick index cards. I don't know if I'm gonna double them all up or just some of them, we'll see. Depends on what I will use them for the journal, because they can be just shaker cards or they can also be shaker pockets. You know, you can glue this on your junk journal and glue these three sides here and this can be your pocket. So you know, this one only has orange and gold and leaves, doesn't have green. This one as well has a lot of leaves and some seed beads and some sequins. So you know, if you have lots of sequins, you can make lots of shaker tags, or like I said, shaker pockets, whatever you want to call them, or depending on how you want to use them in your journals. But you know, and if you don't have cardstock, the index cards are a good material to use as well. And if they're too flimsy like this one, you can just always double them up. This one doesn't have leaves, just the sequins and the seed beads. So when I add them to the journals, I might, you know, do more decorating, like those leaves that I have, I might glue some on the corners, you know, and maybe add dangles. But you will have to see that when I show you the flip through of the book. But this is mask making, and you know, I have been having fun mask making for my journals. So this is mask making shaker cards for the fall journals. Okay, you guys. So the only thing that I realized, since I was using the zigzag stitch, sometimes the sequins get stuck in the middle here inside of the stitch. So if you wanna use just a plain stitch, maybe just a line instead of the zigzag, that would be better. But you know, I like decorating, you know, I think it's more decorative, like a zigzag, but it doesn't matter. I mean, you can do whatever you want. So those are my shaker pockets, or shaker tags, or shaker cards for your junk journals. Okay, you can even use this to put on a card, you know, just glue this on top of a card and that's your shaker card, you know. So if you must make some of this, you can use them in several ways. Okay, and like I said, these are index cards. You can see the back, and I did show you the ones that I double. This is double, so you cannot see the sewing. But I do like to leave them like this too, because I love to feel, you know, this on my fingers, the stitching. Okay, you guys, well, have a great day. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back. I might show you some things that I brought to the craft fair that you haven't seen, in case you want to get some, okay? All right, guys, love you, bye.